Mike Marsh, reigning Olympic champion, is in one. Jeff Williams is in two. Michael Johnson, the world record holder, is in three. Garcia of Cuba in four. Frankie Fredericks, the Olympic silver medalist at 100s, in five. Atto Bolden, the bronze medalist, in six. Stevens in seven. Obadeli Thompson in lane eight. Away first time. Johnson knows he's got to get away very fast indeed in three. He's already picked up Garcia outside him. Frederick's running hard. He's made up ground on Bolden, and it's been a great 100 by these three. Johnson comes into the straight with a lead. Can you believe it? What's the plot? This is fast. He's going to win by miles. He takes the gold medal, 1932, and he set the world record way, way west. Gold goes to Michael Johnson. Frederick took silver. The bronze went to Atto Bolden there. The world record he set on this track some 5 weeks ago has been shattered by over a third of a second. That is staggering sprinting. He wrapped up the gold medal in the first 100 metres, but in the second half of the race, he tore the world record apart. It was his own world record. He tore the field apart, and most importantly, he tore apart Fredericks, Bolden and Mike Marsh, who are the men he may have been worried about in his preparation for this final. That Mike stadium then, in anticipation of this men's 200 metres final. They've already been treated to gold in the last half hour through Derek Adkins and the 400 metre hurdles. That is Michael Johnson starting in at lane three in this 200. World record holder. Just 5 weeks ago, he smashed the very old figures. 1968, Menea, 1979 rather, excuse me, Menea of Italy running 1972. Johnson's world record 1966. He starts in three, the reigning world champion. One man capable of stopping him, we saw just there. Atto Bolden starts in lane six. Bolden, well, his main rival's inside him. There are four men in this who one really has to think about as being the medalists. Mike Marsh is in lane one, the reigning Olympic champion. He is one of the four, but that's not a good lane draw for Marsh. He looked very, very easy in qualifying. He's run 1988 this year, but maybe getting this lane draw, he regrets not having run slightly harder in qualifying. Indeed, Marsh holding the Olympic record, as you can see there. He set that in Barcelona in a semi-final, and he was easing off in the last 10 metres. He didn't have any idea how fast he'd run over the first 180 metres, eased off, and missed the world record of Menea by 1/100th of a second. It is the Olympic record, but it may have just a few minutes of life left in it. That is the full lineup. Frederick starts in lane five, the Namibian. Silver medalist in the 100 metres on Saturday. Silver medalist in this event 4 years ago. Marsh taking gold in Barcelona in front of Fredericks. And Michael Bates, who disappeared without trace. But this man's longevity already well established. World 200 metres champion 91 in Tokyo. 400 metres champion in 93. Took the double last year in 95. And now looking to cup that triumvirate of world championship successes with Olympic double. The disappointment for Johnson, of course, still a very bitter one. And in Barcelona, he was struck with food poisoning a couple of weeks before the championships, lost some 10 pounds in those last 10 or 12 days, and went out in his semi-final. He was a shadow of the Michael Johnson that we'd seen on the Grand Prix circuit only a week or two earlier. There's Mike Marsh, the reigning Olympic champion, fifth in the 100 metres. We know his flat speed is very good. He's the only American who made their team at 100 and 200 metres. This tight lane is going to affect him, though. In lane one, it certainly won't work to his advantage. But the student of psychology may have done the magic with his own mind in the last hour or two since the semi-final. We shall find out. Jeff Williams, his teammate, ran very well in the World Championships last year to take the bronze medal. Williams, who has improved out of all recognition in the last couple of years, one of three Americans in this final, of course. He's in lane two. Outside him, his teammate. Unusually, perhaps uniquely, we have the Americans in lanes one, two, and three here. Michael Johnson, world record holder now at this distance. Didn't get the world record in the 400 he might have been looking for. That surely will come sometime later on this season. But Johnson starts here as favourite, although remember that race in Oslo some 5 weeks ago when he was beaten by Frankie Fredericks. He can be beaten. We all know that. Fredericks knows it, and Johnson knows it. Ivan Garcia starts in lane four. Just 24 years old, Garcia has done tremendously well to get to this stage. He was sixth fastest in qualifying with 20.34, has a best of 20.23, and he could well finish in the top five. Then Frankie Fredericks, former soccer player from Namibia, beat Johnson, as I said, in that race in Oslo. The Olympic silver medalist just a few days ago, won the silver in this event 4 years ago, doesn't want yet another silver. So Frankie Fredericks here has got to go up very hard indeed. He's the fastest man in the field, over 100 metres on paper. This man, though, beat him in the 100 final, Atto Bolden in lane six for Trinidad. Just 22 years old, the youngster of the race, only one man younger than him. And Bolden, very confident. At the time of the last Olympics, he was busy winning world junior titles in Seoul. Patrick Stevens of Belgium, he has done well to get to this stage. The only European in this final, 28 years old now, Stevens, has spent some time over the last couple of years training with Linford Christie, has picked up all the hints and learnt well, and he's done tremendously well to reach this final. And on the outside, the 20-year-old, the youngest in the race from Barbados, Obadele Thompson, world record holder as a junior at 100 metres. Thompson, fifth fastest in qualifying. But the pressure on this man now, beaten by Fredericks in Oslo. Is that playing on his mind? I doubt it. So, so confident. This man, one or two people saying there are question marks over his psychological preparation for races after only finishing second in the 100 metres. That's a qualified only, I say, because of course Bailey set a world record. That proving the speed of this track, and the world record, of course, a distinct possibility here. Johnson then in lane four. There he is. Line up from the inside. Mike Marsh, reigning Olympic champion, is in one. Jeff Williams is in two. Michael Johnson, the world record holder, is in three. Garcia of Cuba in four. Frankie Fredericks, the Olympic silver medalist at 100s, in five. Atto Bolden, the bronze medalist, in six. Stevens in seven. Obadele Thompson in lane eight. Away first time. Johnson knows he's got to get away very fast indeed in three. He's already picked up Garcia outside him. Fredericks running hard. He's made up ground on Bolden. It's been a great 100 by these three. Johnson comes into the straight with a lead. Can you believe it? What's the block? This is fast. He's going to win by miles. He takes the gold medal, 1932, and he set the world record way, way west. Gold goes to Michael Johnson. Fredericks took silver. The bronze went to Atto Bolden there. The world record he set on this track some 5 weeks ago has been shattered by over a third of a second. That is staggering sprinting. He wrapped up the gold medal in the first 100 metres, but in the second half of the race, he tore the world record apart. It was his own world record. He tore the field apart, and most importantly, he tore apart Fredericks, Bolden and Mike Marsh, who are the men he may have been worried about in his preparation for this final. That is incredible. The world record right down close to 19 seconds. Steve, I've never seen anything like it. And another double tonight after the double of Perec.
Well, not that he needed it, but he got the start of his life. And what a fantastic race. It was all won, really, once they came off the bend and Johnson was in the front. There was no coming back for Fredericks. And I tell you what, when they crossed the line, Fredericks and Bolden just looked at each other as though, what was that? And then turned round to look at the time. And then it was another 5 seconds and Fredericks finally started to applaud, not believing what this man had done. That really was something special. Bailey was great in the 100, but this was better. Michael Johnson, second gold medal, second world record of these Olympic Games. It was the perfect race. I'd love to see it all again because he got a fantastic start. Fredericks was fast around the bend, caught Bolden up. We know Bolden can run a good bend, but those two, you have to say, although we're just looking on the clock here, Fredericks ran a new personal best for him and an African record of 19.68. That would have been just outside the old world record, and he's miles behind Johnson. Bolden also a new national record, 19.8. Obadele Thompson in fourth, a national record, 20.14. But all that pales into insignificance behind Michael Johnson. What more can you say? I thought he would do it in the 400, and he's blown it apart in the 200.
Well, Steve, it confirms this is a sprinter's track. This stadium, I think, would be remembered as the home of sprinting. World record in the 100 from Donovan Bailey, 9.84. World record here by a much, much bigger margin from Michael Johnson. Gebre Selassie said this track has been built for the sprinters, not with middle or long distance runners in mind. He said it was very hard, far too hard for the 10,000 and 5,000 metre runners. And this really does confirm it, doesn't it? Johnson here bouncing off that track in those gold spikes of his. I was able to pick one up the other night. I was privileged enough to pick one up the other night after his second round race. And there's nothing to them. It's like three or four sheets of paper in your hand. It's quite astonishing what he runs here, as though he's got wings on his feet as well. 19.32, the world record confirmed. Frederick's 19.68, as Steve says. And third place, Bolden, 19.80. Johnson sees that world record. And surely now, the third gold medal can be his in the 4x400 metres. Everybody's saying no matter what the British do in the first three legs, Johnson will be able to claw them back. His start here, Steve, is lightning. Look at that, he picks up Garcia in about 50 metres from lane three. Coming into the straight, he's got a massive lead over Fredericks and Bolden. It was a good lane draw for them. He had them inside him, outside him, but both of them are supposed to be considerably faster than him over 100 metres. Remember, he's never broken 10 seconds for 100 metres, never shown anything like it, and I'd love to know the time for his first 100 there, even though it was on the bend.
Like, no, he's time for his second 100 even. I mean, it's just incredible. I don't know what to say. Frankie Fredericks has come here, run 9.89 and 19.68 and hasn't won anything. What do you do? Go back to your coach and say, must try harder. When you're up against somebody like this, what do you do? I can tell you that he's got a strapping on his leg on his lap of honour right now. I don't know whether it's just some ice as a precaution, of course. He's got the 4x400 relay to come. It's already been a tough programme for him. He wouldn't have been able to tell from that, though, would you? Well, I thought he had a strapping on his leg, some ice on his leg.
That's
a recording, in fact. I can see him around the far side. He's surrounded by photographers, and I'm pretty sure he's got an ice pack at least anyway around his lower hamstring. But hopefully that's just precautionary. Frankie Fredericks, of course, ever the gentleman, acknowledging one of the all-time greats. No shame to be beaten by somebody of this calibre. And that, we said, didn't we, that Perek might steal his thunder? Don't think so.
Well, hers was a mighty loud clap of thunder. His, something slightly noisier. He's halfway down the back straight at the moment. Fredericks, well, he's probably disappointed with yet another silver medal. Can you imagine? Silver medals in two events in two consecutive games. But Steve, the USA have a stranglehold in this event now. It's the fourth consecutive Olympic 200 gold for the USA. They've won gold in the 200 15 times now since 1896. Michael Johnson takes gold in a world record.
Well, you can see that ice pack on his leg. As I said, hopefully that's just precautionary. He seems to be walking no problem at all. And I'm sure he's not feeling any pain whatsoever at this moment. It's pure joy for Michael Johnson. If Perek was a clap of thunder, this man was a hurricane. He just blew them all away. Came off the top bend with a lead. And he did have the ideal draw with Fredericks and Bolden outside him. And those men ran great. There's nothing they can say about it. They can hold their head up high on the rostrum and say, hey, ran faster than I've ever run before. We were just up against something superhuman. 19.32, still can't get over it.
Flabbergasted, I think, is the word for all the media in the stadium and for a great number of the crowd. The whole crowd still on their feet as Johnson comes round into the straight on a victory lap. And I'm sure we'll see these images in our daily papers tomorrow all over the world. Johnson's time there confirmed as 19.32. Four national records broken in that race. Frederick setting a Namibian record and an area record there in second place. Bolden a national record for Trinidad. And in fourth place, Obadeli Thompson setting a Barbados record of 2014. That knee just strapped as a precaution, I think, Steve, there with some ice. Just hope it's okay for the 4x400 at the weekend. But Michael Johnson enjoying, surely, the greatest moment of his career yet, and that is saying something for a man who has already set world records and won major world titles.
Well, in the stadium you might not be able to hear it, but they're playing unbelievable, and that's what it was. The crowd are singing along to it, and that's what they've seen. Something quite remarkable. Those who had tickets for this will long remember it, and those who've seen it on TV, I'm sure, will also long remember it. Feel privileged to have sat in the stadium and watched this man perform. He really is something special. Thank you, Fredericks. Hats off to him. He ran a great race, but almost outclassed. I don't like to say that somebody as classy as Fredericks is, but he was almost 0.4 behind this man. So, well, Michael Johnson, king of the games.